Have you ever watched a movie or TV show and wondered, how does that technology work?
Definitely.
Well, I know a blockchain when I see one. Today's episode covers one thing and one thing well. We'll look at what happens when blockchain and AI merge. We highlight platforms like AnyTask, LIVEEN, and Actifit, as well as real AI blockchains like Golem, Matrix AI, DeepBrainChain, and SingularityNET. This is the Blockchains of Smart House.
I will be monitoring your accuracy from now on.
Whoa.
No, wait. This is the Blockchains of the Matrix, presented by MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. In terms of iconic movies, The Matrix has it all. An awesome compilation of concepts and ideas. A love story that's actually relevant to the plot. Looking at you, Ready Player One.
I know it's kind of a groaner.
Yup. Stunning visuals. A gripping score. And a very, 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 very well-composed cast. Now, I'm not sure how much background I need to give you on this movie. I mean, it's The Matrix, so I'll keep this short. The Matrix follows computer hacker Neo as he discovers that the world is not anymore the way it used to be.
No!
Hollywood likes to vilify AIs as dangerous or evil. But not always.
I can't do eyes. Eyes is a crime.
AI isn't inherently good or bad, and neither is blockchain. They're tools, and it's what we do with them that matters.
You had my curiosity, but now you have my attention.
In the movie, we are shown that the Matrix simulation code is in fact open source.
Is that
the Matrix? Yeah.
It's presented to us clear as day in this scene where Neo and Cypher talk about the code of the Matrix while Cypher monitors actual code snippets in real time.
You get used to it. I don't even see the code. All I see is blonde, brunette, redhead.
Undeniable proof of blockchain in the Matrix?
I know that's what it looks like, but it's not.
However, blockchains have celebrated the concept of open source ever since the mysterious creator of Bitcoin, Satoshi Nakamoto, began publicly publishing Bitcoin source code. Let's check in on our blockchain terms videos for the definition of open source.
Open source. Here's what's up. The definition of open source is code that is publicly available and usable via special licenses.
Watch the rest and learn more terms on our video channels. These days, there are thousands of blockchain projects that openly publish and share their source code. This helps the blockchains themselves to be more trusted.
You cannot trust anybody.
More often than they should, AI systems can act as black boxes, where sometimes not even the developers themselves know how the AI thinks. The European Union took notice of this, and according to this IBM.com article, recently adopted a law that requires decisions made by machines to be explained in a human-readable form. The article goes on to mention that just as blockchains already bring trust to transactions in a network, they can also become the active component necessary for trusting and auditing decisions made by AI. From what I could gather, my general opinion is that both regulators and ethical AI developers want to bring AI out of its black box, making it more open and trusted. Blockchain can surely play a key role in that.
Bingo.
I believe open source AI code in the movie is a nod to an early attempt by humans to make the AI safer. Now, something still went wrong, very, very wrong.
Pandora doesn't go back in the box.
But I'm not here to judge. I just watch movies and TV shows with blockchain-tinted glasses and point at the screen and be like, oh snap, blockchain?
I'm just a messenger. And right now, I'm gonna prove it to you.
I found an interesting case where an AI generated its own human-readable code in this stxnext.com article. An AI trained in writing code to achieve a specific goal succeeded, according to this screenshot right here. Oh, and the programmer responsible for this feat? He became director of AI at Tesla. You know, that old chestnut.
I mean, you have to be smart. You have to be really smart. You have to use your brain.
Now, don't get me wrong. There are many open source things that are not blockchains, such as the Linux operating system and even VLC player, a versatile media player with over 3 billion downloads. But open source has always been a very large staple of blockchains. And I see that as a nod towards blockchain in the Matrix, not away from it.
Okay.
In the movie, we learn that humans gave birth to AI, then lost control over it, then couldn't shut it down, and had to block the sun to starve the machines of power.
Our arrows will blot out the sun.
Then we will fight in the shade.
To me, this is a strong indication of decentralization, a systemic concept that the machines and AI were likely using as a survival mechanism. Decentralization means that a system is highly resistant to attempts to control it or shut it down. The Bitcoin network is a good example, as it lacks any central point of failure and is secured by an ever-growing network of powerful computers. The computers all run the Bitcoin code, but they are not centrally managed, so you can't really just turn the network off and on again. Yeah, so you can't really do that with a properly decentralized blockchain. Now, it's unclear whether the AI in the Matrix decentralized itself after it became self-aware or was already operating on a decentralized system when it woke up. We can ask those kinds of questions all day long.
We don't have time for 20 questions.
But the fact that the last viable option to stop it is cancel culturing the sun is pretty strong evidence that the AI was already heavily decentralized and virtually unstoppable. These properties are also found in blockchains, albeit with more of a financial security and resilience type energy and less of a stepping on skulls and red-eyed titanium skeleton type energy. Decentralization.
That's what's up.
Yes, Spizzo. But we're not done. It's just another puzzle piece pointing us towards blockchain.
Rude.
In The Matrix Reloaded, we learn of digital entities called Exiles. These are rogue programs that have outlived their purpose and refuse to return to the machine world mainframe for deletion. They appear to be conscious because they make decisions against their prime directive, and also fear death. I'm not sure if that's enough evidence for you, but it's enough for me. I'm not a consciousness expert, okay?
There's nothing I can say that will explain it for you, Neo.
Now, the interesting thing about Exiles is they appear to reveal the structure of the Matrix as truly decentralized, and more importantly, permissionless. They traverse the Matrix as fugitives through the network of doors, and their code runs on nodes in the Matrix without the permission of Squidface. In defiance, even.
Don't tell me what to do.
Shh.
Now, when Squidface locates the Exiles in the Matrix, they run again, relocating to the next safe area. Blockchains are permissionless as well. No one can stop you from executing a transaction on the Bitcoin blockchain. You don't need the permission of a central authority or bank. So as long as you can pay the transaction fee in the form of crypto, you can get your transactions confirmed.
$15, little man, put that in my hand.
In the same way, Exiles can run their consciousness code on Matrix nodes against the wishes of Squidface. Who knows? Maybe they're even using a form of permissionless AI cryptocurrency to pay for CPU cycles in the Matrix blockchain. Now, I know what you might be thinking. This AI-facilitated cryptocurrency must surely be Nano, an open, permissionless digital currency with near-zero latency and no transaction fees, which we discussed at length in the blockchains of In Time. Or maybe it's Arc, with the ability to deploy custom use cases on independent interconnected blockchains, as mentioned in the blockchains of Ready Player One. However, there's actually a much more fitting network that could fulfill this task that you may not have heard of before. The blockchain project Golem puts this fictional concept to work in the real world by offering a decentralized network of computing power governed by blockchain. Developers can access the Golem network to purchase computing power using its native crypto asset, GNT, and users can be rewarded GNT for idle computing power they provide to the network. It's a unified, decentralized supercomputer that is ideal for large computational challenges that can be broken down into parallel tasks. According to the Golem team, Golem can be used for AI purposes. Very interesting stuff. Now here's something that'll really get you thinking, or bake your noodle later on, as it were. In the movie, they put forward a really creative explanation of the concept of deja vu.
What is it?
A deja vu is usually a glitch in the Matrix. It happens when they change something.
So, when something is changed in the Matrix, it causes a glitch, a ripple effect. Blockchain evidence incoming. When a blockchain is running normally, it operates on many different decentralized nodes. These nodes are all in agreement over the state of, quote, reality, or in blockchain's case, the transaction ledger. They all have the same identical data.
Me, me, me.
Me too.
However, sometimes data on different blockchain nodes does not line up with other nodes. This is known as an accidental fork. In some other cases still, the disconnect of data integrity is intentional in the form of an attack called a Sybil attack. This blockchain attack means that the attacker nodes temporarily fool legitimate nodes into believing the attacker nodes are legit.
Obviously, you are mistaken.
It appears the Zion ships in the Matrix broadcast a pirate signal to execute a localized Sybil attack on the network, allowing them to enter the Matrix, as well as spawn guns and supplies.
Bring the ship up to broadcast depth. We're going in.
The attack or mission is carried out before the affected Matrix nodes realize they're off kilter. Then the faulty nodes resynchronize with the main network correctly, and things go back to the way they were. The Matrix blockchain executes fork management, resulting in Deja Vu. Now, don't dwell too much on the details, as they can get pretty dense.
Instead, only try to realize the truth.
What truth?
That it's a blockchain! So, you probably have a curious feeling about what happens when AI and blockchain combine.
It is this feeling that has brought you to me.
The strongest case for blockchain in the Matrix is that blockchain and AI are already converging in the real world, even as we speak now. Or wait, what was the line, Morpheus?
Even now, in this very room.
Yes, precisely. Not only that, but discussions about that convergence have already been happening for years.
You recall what I told you of the convergence?
Yes.
According to a comprehensive article on frontiersin.org titled Convergence of Blockchain, IoT, and AI, the authors make this conclusion. Blockchain, IoT, and AI are technologies that can be combined in multiple dimensions. We argue that a convergence of these innovations will take place, since business models, products, and services will benefit from the combination of these technologies. Such business models could be widely applied to any autonomous agents such as sensors, cars, machines, trucks, cameras, and other IoT devices. These agents could send and receive money autonomously and leverage AI and data analytics to make decisions as independent economic agents. I'm sorry, did they just say agents?
The future is our world, Morpheus. The future is our time.
I'm a little nervous now. This fall 2019 Forbes.com article proposed a theoretical example in online product recommendations, where AI systems can use blockchain to facilitate the sharing of data without an intermediary. Multiple smaller retail sites can be connected through a blockchain to share trusted personalized information. As a connected group, they could compete with sites like Amazon and Walmart, who have already developed their own data systems to gather this information about their customers. In today's world, we constantly give our personal data to corporations and don't have any real control over what they do with it.
Well, there has to be something that we can do.
There is, Neo. With blockchain involved, we would truly own our data outright and choose which entities we want to access our data and which ones we don't. We can also receive cryptocurrency rewards in exchange for sharing data. Why?
Because I believe in something.
I believe we can turn the tables and take our data back.
You are going to need my help.
Okay, Trinity, you can come along too. While not specifically involved in AI at the moment, to my knowledge at least, the blockchain project LIVEEN is a great example of users taking back control of their data and being rewarded for their everyday activity. Actifit, focusing on fitness-related user activities, is another solid example. So let's now take a look at projects that are fusing AI with blockchain in the real world, but for good reasons, not apocalypse reasons.
Welcome to the real world.
I would certainly be remiss if I didn't at least mention Matrix AI. Yes, you heard that name right.
That's the name of the movie!
Nevertheless, Matrix AI Network is purporting itself to be an efficient AI-empowered open-source blockchain platform. On the Matrix AI Network, MAN tokens are used for rewards, payment, and digital asset authentication. The solutions they are building will even integrate with NFTs, or non-fungible tokens.
Oh yes, very soon. They are building it now.
We discuss NFTs at length in one of our previous episodes, The Blockchains of Ready Player One. Check it out, yo.
Okay. Do it. Mm-hmm. Do it.
DeepBrainChain is another example of AI fusing with blockchain. DeepBrainChain used top scientists to develop a decentralized, low-cost, and privacy-protecting AI computing platform powered by blockchain. Their website highlights successful tests of the network in real-life training scenarios.
Whoa.
The DeepBrainChain network is underpinned by the crypto asset DBC. SingularityNET is a really, really interesting blockchain project using AI because it's layering an additional use case on top of the already interesting AI industry.
You have to see it for yourself.
SingularityNET builds and maintains a global AI marketplace that lets anyone create, share, and monetize AI services at scale.
AI code is there, free and open source on the internet right now. It's just hard to find and hard to use. So SingularityNET can complete that connection between AI developers and AI users.
Yep, that's Ben Gertzel, former chief scientist of Hanson Robotics and current CEO of SingularityNET. And that's Sophia, Hanson Robotics' world-famous humanoid robot that's taken such stages as The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon and many others.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. I won.
On SingularityNet's AI marketplace, you can browse real AI services available for rent by using the SingularityNet platform. Developers can create a type of AI employee and earn cryptocurrency for the work that their AIs do. Now, if you don't think that's cool, then just give up. Unsubscribe, shut it all down, pack it all up, okay? I mean, come on. Basically, Fiverr for non-human workers? That is cool.
Yeah, Mikey, I think he likes it.
So take a look at SingularityNet and check out all of the amazing advanced AI services at your fingertips.
That's it? It only does hot dogs?
No, and a not hot dog.
But hey, you're a human, not an AI. How can you earn cryptocurrency for your skills? AnyTask, powered by Electroneum.
Brought to you by Carl's Jr.
AnyTask.com is a blockchain-powered marketplace intended for both freelancers, of the human variety, and their customers. It's 100% real.
What is real? How do you define real?
I don't know. I define it as a website that you can really go to. Woosah, Morpheus, dang. On AnyTask.com, you can find or provide freelance services in design, marketing, writing, translation, photography, videography, technology, games, lifestyles, crafts, even NFTs. AnyTask has enlisted the services of Electroneum, which means that freelancers don't need to have a bank account to get paid, nor are they required to pay seller fees. So put your skills to work and earn crypto while doing it. But you better hurry, because AI might just be catching up.
They took our jobs!
Never send a human to do a machine's job.
So there you have it, the blockchains of the Matrix. And if you didn't know about blockchains until today, well, now you gotta go watch 1,000 videos about it, because thirst for blockchain knowledge is unquenchable.
To deny our own impulses is to deny the very thing that makes us human.
Check out our other episodes, like The Blockchains of In Time, Ready Player One, Black Mirror, and Altered Carbon, or go to marketsquare.io, the new homepage for the decentralized web, to discover and connect with your favorite blockchain-powered projects and businesses. See you next time.